See, my dear boys, our topic is Geldahl's method. So, for what purpose this Geldahl's method is applicable? That is for estimation of nitrogen in organic compounds. Estimation of nitrogen in organic compounds, it is done by one of the methods, that is Geldahl's method. Geldahl's method. Now, what is the way to find out this Geldahl's method? So, the basic information from this Geldahl's method is, it is based on back titration. The concept is based on back titration. So, something X is there, how much X is identified? So, by using that, we calculate the estimation, that is how much nitrogen is present in your given organic compound. So, it is by back titration. Okay. Now, what is the method? What is the process for the estimation of this nitrogen by this Geldahl's method? So, see, my dear boys. So, take a flask. So, it is the flask made by Geldahl. So let it be, it is called as Geldahl's flask. It is Geldahl's flask. So this is Geldahl's flask. So in this Geldahl's flask, take a known mass of organic compound to which nitrogen is estimated. So it is a known mass of organic compounds having nitrogen. So in this organic compound, how much weight is taken? We know that. Let it be 10 grams or 20 grams like that. So we know the weight of this organic compound. No doubt we know there is nitrogen. There is nitrogen. But our target is how much nitrogen is there? That is, percentage of nitrogen in it is how much? It is the question to solve by this method. How much percentage of nitrogen is present in this organic compound, this known weight of organic compound? For this purpose, so add to this, so to this organic compound, add concentrated H2SO4. Add concentrated H2SO4. So that is the organic compound is dissolved there. So something is there. So because it is nitrogen, all nitrogenous compounds are basic in nature in your organic chemistry. That is why acid is added. This base is dissolved in this acid. So to this, add K2SO4. To this, add K2SO4. So for increasing the boiling point of H2SO4, this K2SO4 is added. And also, to this add CuSO4 or mercury as catalyst for this process. Okay, so now the entire arrangement is boiled. So the entire, that means in this Geldahl's flask, our organic compound, we know the mass of that organic compound having nitrogen. So H2SO4 is added to improve that boiling point. So K2SO4 and a little copper sulfate are, if you are added as catalyst, the entire mixture is heated, is boiled thoroughly. Now, what happened after this boiling? So no doubt we know something nitrogen is present in this organic compound. The entire this nitrogen present in your organic compounds is completely converted into The entire nitrogen present in this organic compound is converted into ammonium sulfate. So after boiling, the total nitrogen present in your organic compound is completely converted into ammonium sulfate. Completely converted into ammonium sulfate. Okay, so now the total nitrogen in your organic compound is now in ammonium sulfate. If you find out the percentage of nitrogen here, that should be equal to here. That should be equal to here. So now, how much is nitrogen is there? So in this form, ammonium sulfate. So because ammonium sulfate is nothing but ammonium salt, this ammonium salt is now treated with NaOH. So that gives, that liberates ammonia gas. Ammonia gas is liberated. That means the total nitrogen present in ammonium sulfate is now in ammonia. That means here nitrogen is converted here. That means the total nitrogen present in ammonia is automatically equal to the nitrogen present in the given organic compound. Now estimate how much is nitrogen present in the liberated ammonia. So here I am going to find out the percentage of nitrogen. It is automatically equal to here. Okay. So this is the method here. So to estimate this nitrogen, because ammonia is a base, this ammonia is estimated with the help of known concentration, that is nothing but known concentration means standard solution of acid. Because it is a base, that is estimated, that is titrated against a known concentrated solution of acid. That acid may be either H2SO4 or HCl. So by using this in particular matter boys, so this is excess in case any. Excess of H2SO4 or HCl, which is nothing but standard solution. That standard solution is used to estimate nitrogen here. So see here. So in ammonia and H2SO4, these two are involved in reaction. So automatically, gram equivalent of ammonia should be equal to gram equivalents of acid. Gram equivalents of ammonia is equal to gram equivalents of acid. So then only the reaction takes place. Whenever a chemical reaction takes place, so automatically those two reactants gram equivalents must be equivalent, because here one of the reactants is ammonia and the other one is excess of H2SO4. So for exact neutralization, gram equivalents of ammonia is equal to gram equivalents of acid. But this acid is in excess. That means, so a little something, this acid, gram equivalent, but which is in excess. So that means let it be 10 gram equivalents are there. Here 5 gram equivalents of ammonia may be there. It is, we know, 10 gram equivalents. So that means this 5 is equal to this 5 only. Here 5 gram equivalents reacts with 5 gram equivalents of acid. So that means something is remained. How much is remained here? Instead of 10, 5 gram equivalents are removed. 5 gram equivalents. So, but we don't know the exact 5 gram equivalents here directly. But we know something is reacted this one. So, a little excess, that HCl is existing. Now, I am going to find out this excess HCl4. Is how much is the excess HCl4 is present? So, that means Here HCSO4, we are taking excess amounts than required. Excess amounts than required. Something is reacted here. So unreacted HCSO4 actually exists. That unreacted HCSO4, now I am going to find out with the help of any OH solution. NaOH solution. So here, gram equivalents of NaOH is equal to here, gram equivalents of unreacted HCSO4. That means, so by knowing this value, that is automatically equal to this one. That means, how much actually taken here, we know. So let it be 10 gram equivalents actually taken. How much is remaining, I don't know. That is calculated with the help of this gram equivalents of NaOH. So this gram equivalents of NaOH, let it be 3 gram equivalents. That means, so 3 gram equivalents of our acid is there. That means, unreacted acid is 3 gram equivalents. Now, so in this 10, 3 is for this one. Now remaining 7, that 7 is reacted here. Now 7 gram equivalents of acid is there. Now 7 gram equivalents of acid is nothing but 7 gram equivalents of ammonia. That means how much ammonia is there? That is the 7 gram equivalents. Okay, so indirectly we are taking here excess is there. That excess amount is calculated with the help of back titration, because already one titration is conducted. This ammonia is titrated against HCSO4. Ammonia is titrated against HCl. One titration is completed, but excess of ammonia is there. Excess of acid is there. That excess of acid is once again titrated with the help of base. That is NaOH. So first of all, calculate excess. That excess is utilized for first of all, calculate equivalence of NaOH. So that is exactly equal to unreacted HCSO4. That means that one total minus this one is equal to reacted for this one. So by using this value, we calculate how much nitrogen actually exists. How much nitrogen actually exists in percentage rate by using formula. That is, percentage of nitrogen is equal to 1.4 into molarity of acid into basicity of that acid into volume of acid for ammonia. For ammonia, this is it. For this, how much volume of acid is taken? By weight of organic compounds taken. Here, we know actually known weight of organic compound is taken. That known weight is used here. So this is the formula used to calculate percentage of nitrogen in your organic compound by using Geldahl's method. 1.4 into molarity of acid into basicity of acid. Molarity of acid into basicity of acid. This is nothing but normality, which is also declared as normality of acid. If normality is directly given to you, so by using that molarity into basicity is nothing but normality. Use that normality directly. Don't use that basicity. Okay, so this is the formula used to calculate percentage of nitrogen by this method. So see here, my dear boys. So something nitrogen is there. This nitrogen is converted into ammonium sulfate. So this is treated with NaOH. So it's converted into ammonia. Ammonia is a purely base. That base is estimated with the help of known standard solution of the HCSO4, excess HCSO4. Okay, so that means, so this ammonia is added to this one. So that means gram equivalents of this ammonia is equal to gram equivalents of reacted HCSO4. Something unreacted HCSO4 is there. That is, which is an excess amount. That excess amount is how much is there is estimated with the help of NaOH. So by using this value here, unreacted acid is identified. That means, so by subtracting original value with this unreacted value, so that is used for this one. By taking these values, so we are taking calculations. That is, the percentage of nitrogen is equal to 1.4 into molarity of acid. So we know HCSO4. So how much is molarity and how much is normality? So molarity of acid into basicity of HCSO4. So if in case of HCl is there, that is HCl, that is basicity is what? So volume of acid used for this
ammonia.
So from this volume of vegetation used for this one is identified. Total 100, let it be total 100. Here 30 is used, remaining 70 is used for this one. Okay, so that's the back titration technique is applied. So this volume of HgSO4 is collecting from these experiments. Okay, so this is the way to find out the percentage of nitrogen by Geldahl's method. So Geldahl's method. So here, my dear boys, please listen here. This method has some limitations. What are the limitations of this method? What are the limitations of this method? So limitations are, one, this method is not suitable. So this method not, just a minute, not suitable to estimate nitrogen in one azo compounds, N double bond N compounds. This is nothing but azo compounds and two nitro compounds, NO2, nitro compounds. And the third point, it is nitrogen in ring. Nitrogen, if nitrogen is present in ring, so that ring nitrogen is also not estimated by this method. So for example, nitrogen ring means there is pyridine there. Their nitrogen is in ring form. So this nitrogen is not estimated by this method. Next, nitro compounds, already we know the function of that is NO2. So this nitrogen is also not estimated by this method. So azo compounds, this nitrogen is also not estimated by this method. Why is that? Because, so this method is totally formation of ammonium sulfate and their formation of ammonia. That means entire nitrogen is converted into ammonia. But in this compound, this entire nitrogen is not converted into ammonia. Not totally converted into ammonia. That means total nitrogen is not estimated by this method. That's why there are certain limitations. So Geldahl method is not applicable for azo compounds identified. That is nitrogen estimation of nitrogen in azo compounds, nitro compounds, and nitrogen which is present in ring conditions. So these are the limitations of this Geldahl's method. Hope it is easy for you. Okay. So my dear boys, is this clear? Is this clear? First of all, take a known weight of our organic compound to be estimated, that is nitrogen percentage. So to this, concentrated HgSO4 is added. To this, K2SO4 to increase the boiling point, because entire nitrogen is converted into HgSO4, it requires more and more temperature. So that is the boiling point you should increase. So to this, to increase the that is dissolution condition and conversion condition. So mercury is used as a catalyst. So all this adding and then heating it. Entire nitrogen present in your given organic compound first converted to ammonium sulfate and then converted into ammonia. So the total nitrogen present in ammonia must be equal to total nitrogen present in your given organic compounds. So this nitrogen is estimated with the help of excess of HgSO4 something. That means this ammonia is passed through this excess of HgSO4. So than required. So something. That means ammonia is completely neutralized there. Still something excess HgSO4 is there. The excess HgSO4 volume is identified with the help of NaOH solution. So that volume is used here. So NaOH, that means unreacted HgSO4 is collected here. So total minus unreacted is equal to, automatically reacted to ammonia. Therefore, so that volume is collected here. We know the bacteria of acid and monoidea of acid and 1.4. We know remaining all are we know and except this one. Then except value is collected by this one method. Okay. So this is Geldahl's method. Right? It is very, very important. So some problems we are going to take based on this concept. Okay. So hope it is easy. So now after taking problems, so no doubt some doubts are there in your mind. Those will be clarified, no doubt at all. Please wait. Thank you. See the problems based on this topic. 1.2 grams of an organic compound on gel dialysation liberates ammonia which consumes which consumes 30 cm³ of 1 NHCl. Ustha. The percentage of nitrogen is equal to dash. So no doubts, all values are directly given to you. What is the formula there? We use that formula is, so solution for this one is, percentage of nitrogen is equal to 1.4 into molarity of acid into basicity. So instead of these two places, normality of acid is also used, into volume of acid used for ammonia by weight of organic component. So that is equal to 1.4 into, so normality of acid is given to you, that is 1. So volume of acid for ammonia. So see here, gel dialysation, ammonia which consumes 30 ml, that is this 30 ml is only for ammonia and no excess is there. Therefore, that is by 30. By weight of organic compound is taken as 1.2 grams. So after final calculation, which is equal to 35. So 35% of nitrogen is available. 35% of that one. So it is easier. So most of the students feel very, very difficult on this problem set. We know the problem formula. It is easy to calculate. So please be mind, percentage of nitrogen is equal to 1.4 into molarity of acid into basicity or normality. Instead of these two, you should use normality. Into volume of acid, used for ammonia by weight of organic component. Next problem. So it is simple one because it is first one. So next one. During estimation of nitrogen, present in an organic compound, by Geldof's method, the ammonia, evolved from, of an organic compound. Neutralized by 10 ml of 1MHTSO4. 10 ml of 1MHTSO4. Percentage of nitrogen is equal to dash. Easy and calculate it. All are directly given to you. So percentage of nitrogen is equal to 1.4 into molarity of acid into basicity of that acid into volume of H2SO4 for ammonia by weight of organic compounds. That is equal to 1.4 into molarity of acid H2SO4, it is 1, into basicity of H2SO4 is 2, into volume of H2SO4 for ammonia, how much it is 10 mRNA for ammonia directly given to you, 10 by weight of organic compound 0.5 grams, 0.5 mRNA. So the final value is 56 mRNA. Therefore, 56% of nitrogen is available. 56% of nitrogen. So easy. Please remind that formula. Okay. Next one. A little bit. So generally, in our examinations, so coming out model is very, very important. grams of an organic compound was dehydrated and ammonia evolved, and ammonia evolved was absorbed in 50 ml of semimolar H2SO4. The residual acid required 131 ml of 0.25 mNaOH. Percentage of nitrogen is equal to dash. Actually, this is the important model anyway. So, something excess is given to you. That excess is neutralized with remaining NaOH. So, how much is the volume of acid taken? So, here, 50 ml of semimolar H2SO4 is taken in. Semimolar means half mN, which is equal to 0.5 mL solution, which is an excess amount. And this value is not used for ammonia. So see here, the residual acid means something acid is there. After reacting with ammonia, some acid is there. That remaining acid required 131 of 0.25 mNaOH solution. So that's why you should use volume of acid used for ammonia. So that's why, first of all, how much is utilized for ammonia? Volume of H2SO4 used for ammonia is equal to how much? First, calculate this one. How to calculate this one? So, first of all, gram equivalents of this H2SO4. Now, I am taking. So, first step, I want to find out this volume of H2SO4. Therefore, for this purpose, gram equivalent of H2SO4 is equal to gram equivalents of NaOH. Gram equivalents of H2SO4 is equal to gram equivalents of NaOH. That means volume of acid into normality of acid is equal to volume of base into normality of base. Gram equivalent is nothing but normality into volume. Volume in liters or milliliters, milli equivalents of not equivalents. I am taking milli equivalents because milliliters are taken here. Here also milli equivalents. Milli equivalents of NaOH is taken. So milli equivalents of acid is equal to milli equivalents of NaOH. So how much is the milli equivalents of acid? So we don't know the NaOH required volume. Therefore, volume of acid, we don't know. Normality of acid is that way, sir. Volume is given to you, sir. But this total volume not only for this NaOH. So something reacted with ammonia and something remaining is reacted with NaOH. That's why. So how much actually reacted with ammonia, I'm going to find out. So normality of acid, that is normality means molarity into its basicity there. 0.5 into basicity of HCSO4 is 2 Na. Is equal to volume of base, 131 into normality of base. Molarity and normality for this NaOH is same, therefore 0.25. From this, volume of acid is equal to, so finally we calculate, that is the 32.75 ml. This is for NaOH. Therefore, for ammonia, volume of H2SO4 is equal to total volume minus volume for NaOH. Therefore, total volume actually how much is taken? 50. Minus volume of NaOH, volume for NaOH is 32.75, which is equal to 50 minus 32.75 means 17.25 ml. This is volume of HCSO4 for ammonia. Now apply the formula. What is that formula? Therefore, percentage of nitrogen is equal to 1.4 into molarity of HCSO4. Molarity of HCSO4, this is 0.5 into basicity 2 into volume of HCSO4 for ammonia. That is 17.25 by weight of organic compound is taken. That is this much and 0.4422. And that is the final we will get the value 54.6%. That is the final value. It is very, very important model, boys. 99% this model problems will appear in your mains exam. So this is the total volume actually given. This total volume is not used for this ammonia. So something is utilized for ammonia. Remaining is reacted with this ammonia, NaOH. That's right. How much volume of NaOH actually reacted for ammonia, NaOH? First calculate. So total minus this value is subtracted. That is utilized for automatically ammonia. So that ammonia value is your problem. So is this clear? Okay. So take your pen and paper. I will give one more problem based on this topic. Okay. So you should calculate. Ammonia obtained from 0.4 grams of an organic compound by Geldahl's method was absorbed in 30 ml of 0.25 m H2SO4, 0.25 m H2SO4. The excess acid was neutralized by the addition of by the addition of 30 ml of 0.2 m NaOH. Percentage of nitrogen is equal to dash. I'm waiting for you. First of all, calculate how much is used for ammonia. How much volume of H2SO4 used for ammonia? Use formula VNA 31.5. Yes, correct. Moria. First, find out volume of acid into normality of acid is equal to volume of base into normality of base. That is, volume of acid into normality of acid, that is 0.25 into 2 ra. Is equal to volume of base, that is 30 into 0.2 normality. So there from this volume of acid is equal to 12 ml. It is for NaOH. Therefore, for ammonia, volume of acid is equal to 30 minus 12 ra, which is equal to 18 ml. Therefore, percentage of nitrogen is equal to 1.4 into molarity of acid 0.25 into normality of acid 2 into volume of acid used for ammonia, that is 18, by weight of organic compound, that is 0.4. So finally we will get, that is 31.5%. So this is different model problems based on Del-Dall method to estimate how much nitrogen is actually present in your given organic compounds.